please welcome to the stage Texas State Director and National Legislative Advisor at Human Coalition Action, Chelsey Youman.
Well, good morning. How are y'all today? What an incredible lineup we've had. I am so honored to be with you today after 50 years of praying and 50 years of serving pregnant women in need, after 50 years of death, frankly, by abortion, 63 million children aborted. I'm standing before you today in a post-Roe world. Yeah. Praise the Lord that He had mercy on us, that He answered our prayer, and that it is time for healing to begin and life to begin in our country. It is a beautiful time to be a part of it and to say that my children, my three sons, and your children and your grandchildren will be a part of the first post-Roe generation. That is powerful. But as we celebrate, we have to remember our work is beginning. And I'm here to tell you that a few things ensued after Roe was overturned. The first is lives are being saved. The most important thing. Yes, yes. But the second thing is that the liberals have had the biggest tantrum of a lifetime since Roe was overturned. They're going crazy. It has been a very, very busy few months since Roe was overturned. They've been busy vandalizing pregnancy resource centers and churches. Over 90 have been vandalized violently. They've been busy sending, if you even saw as recently as last week, Senator Warren and her minions sent a demand letter to Heartbeat International, one of the largest organizations serving women in the country, calling them before Congress, saying you have to answer to us for what your private Christian nonprofit is doing when they serve women. Absolute abuse of power. And I think that's just the beginning. They're going to ride this pony all the way into midterms and make this their issue. But we know something that they don't. And that is that when you look at the human child growing in the womb of that woman, it is undeniable the humanity of that child. That God is creating that child with a purpose, with gifts and talents and intellect, with maybe weaknesses for some of us, that child is beautifully and wonderfully made. But so is that child's mom. And this is where we come together, because I'm going to tell you a little bit about the moms that we're seeing at Human Coalition. These moms come in, and she's pregnant, right? Unexpectedly. She's surprised. The first thing she's feeling is fear and anger. She's angry and scared because she also already has another child, statistically. 60% already have one child they're trying to feed. If she has a job, it's an hourly paying job, and she doesn't know how she's going to take off work and feed her child and feed her new baby. Maybe she's not paying rent. Maybe she's not in safe housing. Maybe she's living in her car, which happens a lot for our clients. Some of them are homeless. They don't have insurance. They don't have Medicaid. They don't know what they're going to do. Some of them are figuring out which bills to pay that they can shut off the other bills next month. So this month I have water, this month I have heat, this month I have food. This is her reality. And so when she comes to us, we might be the first person to look her in the eye and say, you are beautifully and wonderfully made. And you have a purpose for your life. And God doesn't make accidents. And that God is using this moment right here in your life to turn things around. And He's made you able. He's made you intelligent. He's made you capable and adaptable. We might be the first person in her life to look at her and say, you are not alone and you matter and you can do this. Because for 50 years, she's been told by Planned Parenthood she can't. That's not empowerment. So a Human Coalition, where we step into that moment, is the most critical moment in her and that growing child inside of her's life to see that fear and anger switch to hope and switch to possibilities and switch to dreaming. And so we can talk all day long, and I'm more than happy to do this, about the Texas Heartbeat Act, which I was honored to help with and work hard on that bill. And we can talk all day long, thank you, about protecting at conception, which is the ultimate goal in every single state. But until we reach this mother, that is this critical piece of the entire equation. As they're trafficking women across state lines into your state and into California in droves by the thousands, abortion trafficking is happening now as we speak. Planned Parenthood in Charlotte is up 1/3 since Roe was overturned. I know, I'm here to tell you the brutal reality is they're committed to death. And they're going to do it any way they can. And if I could speak to anyone in the country, it would be y'all. It would be y'all, because y'all are in this gap, in this moment where you're going to be surrounded, landlocked by states that are protecting life. And in North Carolina, you start at 20 weeks protection. Well, 85% of abortions are done by 8 weeks. And over half of them are done by the pill, which means she never leaves her house. So women are logging online. They're having a consultation with an international doctor. They're getting a prescription for an abortion filled in an Indian pharmacy, and it's mailed to her door, and she's never left her house. She doesn't even have to go to Planned Parenthood anymore. And this is happening by the tens of thousands. And the women are calling us, traumatized by their experiences. They're calling us, saying, I have 4 pills in front of me. What do I take when? And we say, don't take those pills. We don't know what's in them. It is a crisis. And our work is beginning. And here are a few numbers so that you guys can understand the trafficking that's coming into North Carolina. Planned Parenthood, from their mouths, has said all roads lead to North Carolina for abortion. All roads lead. They said if we lose North Carolina, we're done. It's our job to make abortion done. It's our job. It is not good enough to say, I'm okay with New Mexico allowing human trafficking. It's not enough to say, I'm okay with Colorado allowing children to die legally. We are not done until abortion is finished in our country. And we have failed. We have failed as a society if that's the best we have to offer women. If the lie that we have to offer them is you can't do it. And we send them back to the circumstances that brought them into that clinic to begin with. And so that's why I'm here to say that the estimate for North Carolina from Planned Parenthood publicly is about 70,000 women, up to 70,000 women will be coming to your state for abortions, in addition to the 30,000 that happen every year already. So 100,000 children a year can die in this state. And I think it's so important that we just know that it is time to engage. Now is not the time to hit pause and do our victory lap. I'm so grateful that the Lord answered our prayer this summer, but we've got work to do and women to serve. And at Human Coalition, what that looks like is about 11 years ago, our founders were sitting around, they're a bunch of businessmen from the corporate world, and they were sitting in their living room, and they were saying after their Bible study one night, what is the first thing a woman does when she finds out she's pregnant? She gets on her phone and she looks up, where's the abortion clinic near me? And they said, what if we competed with Planned Parenthood for her? What if we pop up on her phone and she clicks through to us and she's immediately on the phone with a nurse who loves her and is compassionate for her and says, how can I help her? And asks her the question nobody in her life asks her. Not her partner who's pushing her to get the abortion, not her employer who's gonna now pay for her abortion. And we say, what do you want? How do you feel about this? And so right then and there, they made their first ad. And a woman called through and clicked the number, and their phone rang. And right there in their living room, they picked up the phone, and their first life was saved through Human Coalition. We have since grown. We are now saving close to 25,000 lives this fall in the last 10 years. All by being there for her. And so as we're looking for what it looks like in the future for you guys and your state and the women next to you, they're sitting next to you in church, they're your daughters, they're your nieces, they're your cousins, they're one in four of us, right? We're saying, what does it look like to love her so that abortion is truly unnecessary? And what does it look like to care for her holistically and to say, we in North Carolina are not going to stand for killing our children to succeed. It's not good enough. And so as we look forward, it's time to engage. Lives are at stake. Thank you guys so much for the work you've already done. Thank you for volunteering. Thank you for your support in the movement, and know that it continues. We've got our work set out ahead of us, but it is meaningful work and it is good work. And it's a gospel opportunity to tell her she is loved and she is able and that she has support. That's our goal every day. Thank you guys for your time today.